In this video, I explain how to calculate enthalpy of wet steams. Okay, so find out the enthalpy of the wet steam, we compulsory need to use the steam tables. Okay, so in the last video I explained how to calculate enthalpy of the water. Okay, so this enthalpy of the water can be calculated directly from the equations, okay, or either by using the steam tables. Okay, so by two way we can find out this enthalpy of the waters. But when we need to find out this enthalpy of the wet steam, we need to compulsory use the steam tables. Okay, so first we understand the problem statements. Calculate the enthalpy of 5 kg of 80% dry steam at a pressure of 10 bars. Okay, so in a last video we find out enthalpy of water. For that the temperature is given. Now in these numericals the pressure is given, mass is given, and the percentage of dryness fraction is given. Okay, so here percentage of the dryness fraction is given, that's why we are able to understand this is the numerical of wet steam. Okay, because here no other parameter is mentioned to find out the enthalpy of wet steam. Okay, but when this dry steam is given or dryness fraction is given, okay, we can easily understand that is the wet steam is there. Okay, so data given is first mass of water, okay, that is a steam is given, that's why we mentioned the ms, that is a 5 kg. Okay, dryness fraction x is given for the steam, it is a 80% means 0.8, and the pressure of steam generation is given 10 bar. Okay, so enthalpy of the wet steam is find out by using this equation. Okay, so enthalpy of the wet steam is denoted as the h, wet means weight, is equal to mass of steam in bracket hf plus x into hfg. Means why this summation is there? Okay, for that I already mentioned the one video, that is a formations of a steam. Okay, so in the formation of the steam various part is there. I also make the video for the different types of this equation for the different types of the steams. Okay, so you can understand this equation from that last video. Okay, for that I already provide this link in the descriptions as well as in the card. So we need to find out this value of hf and the value of hfg from the steam tables. Okay, and for finding out this value from the steam tables, either we require temperatures or either we require the pressures. Okay, so here this pressure is given. So here you see this is the steam table for the pressure. Okay, so in the first column here you see this is the pressure is given in the kilopascals. Okay, so 10 bar is equal to 1000 kilopascals. Okay, and we require the hf. Okay, so here you see in this enthalpy hf is here and hfg is here. Okay, so we need to read these two value. So hf is 762.51 kilojoule per kilogram. Okay, and the hfg is the 2014.6. okay, so we take these two value and putting in these equations. Okay, so first we need to write down this value, okay, in the notebook, that is hf and hfg. Okay, then after we putting this value in this equation, so mass of steam is given 5, hf is 762.15, x means dryness fraction is given 0.8, and the hfg is the 214.6, and then we calculate in the calculators and we get this answer that the enthalpy of the wet steam is the 11870.95 kilojoules. Okay, so here we multiplied with this mass, that's why we get this answer in kilojoules. Otherwise here you see the answer, if the enthalpy is the unit of this enthalpy is the kilojoule per kilograms. Okay, so here this kilojoule per kilogram is multiplied with this mass. Okay, so mass in this kilogram, so this kilogram is cancelled, that's why unit is coming this kilojoules. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you learn something, then like the video and subscribe my channels for watching the more video related to property of steams, BME or EME subject or other subject of this mechanical engineering. For BME or EME, various link is provided in descriptions as well as in car. For other subject, I request to visit the playlist.